every time I go to Minneapolis, Minnesota, and appear on Evine, y'all hear me talking about this one man, Stan the Candyman. Well, I am so happy to tell all my friends out there and introduce all my friends to Stan the Candyman. Stan Strickland is a wonderful friend of mine, and he makes all those goodies, all those wonderful sweets for me that I sell on Evine that I bring to y'all.
And steal your cake recipes.
Yes, yes, and he makes my cakes for me. And I just thank you so much, and I'm so happy that everybody's going to be able to put a face with a name, Stan the Man.
Well, I'm glad you invited me today, Paula. I was talking earlier before you got here because you were
Max.
Late. You were late as usual.
I was late, y'all.
Just kidding, Paula.
No,
I was
no,
talking earlier that why I think Savannah has done so well had to do with you. I said it was the book first, and then it was Paula. Because I remember when your restaurant was down close to my second store, which we now have 17, when we were down in our second store, and you moved a block away, it hurt our business by 10%. So I knew it was important to have you in Savannah.
Oh, my gosh.
So, and now we've been able to spread that throughout the country by TV and media. It's been good for us.
Oh, well, Stan, he has been so successful. He was like me, y'all. He didn't go to work until he was, how old, Stan?
I think I got it all together about 50. Actually, well, I started working hard at 45, but I've been doing the candy business since 78. So however many years ago that is, it's been about 40 years, almost 40 years we've been making candy.
Wow. Well, Stan and his company makes the best pralines, y'all, and gophers. That's Michael's favorite. It's the gophers.
Yeah. You know, we may change the name of that thing to Loggerhead too now, because we're
Loggerhead.
Giving money. Here off state off of Georgia and off the coast of Florida, you know, Loggerhead's a big deal.
Yeah.
So we're going to be changing that name from a gopher to a loggerhead, and we're going to donate money from that item for every pound we sell.
That's great, because all of our big beautiful turtles, they're probably endangered, aren't they?
They are endangered, and there's a big study on them here. So we think it's a good mix.
Yes.
Good mix.
Well, out of how many eggs does a turtle lay?
Oh, Lord, it's a load bunch, 50, 60.
Yeah.
It's a lot.
And how many of those eggs survive?
I think they say 5% or something. It's very small.
Yeah, maybe a couple of those eggs will survive.
Yeah. We hope our...
not get eaten. So that's wonderful.
We want all of ours to be eaten.
All your loggerheads. Yeah. The one with caramel and pecans.
Yeah, right.
Well, I tell you what, I don't know which... You could probably tell me... which product people enjoy the most.
Well, you said it in the
Evine.
Beginning. And Evine. Well, Evine, there's a toss-up, I think, between something pretty new you're doing is the pecan log roll or pecan log roll.
Listen, those pecan logs, you know, as a kid, Stan, I would start screaming, there's the Stuckies, you know, because you had to get that pecan log, and they're so good, and I slice them and I put them in brownies or my gooey butter cake mixes. Oh, my goodness.
I'm glad to hear that.
That item's
really done well here lately, and it's a new item for you. And also the coconut cake, which you've done well with for years.
Yes.
Everybody still likes that cake.
Yes, yes.
But
and then we got the dreamsicle cake. It reminds me of that dreamsicle that we ate as children with the orange sherbet and the vanilla ice cream. And then the strawberry cake. They love the strawberry cake.
And that's a good time of year for that. You know, sometimes it makes me think of that.
Yeah, yeah. And they're so pretty. And one time you did for me three of the loaf cakes.
Yes.
And I thought that was a fabulous idea.
We did two different ways. We did a spring loaf cake that had some spring items in it. Then we did a regular layer cake. Trio,
right,
which was our mainstay, the praline cake.
And, right.
Now we need to call it a loggerhead cake, but it was called a turtle cake.
Yeah.
But those are the items we make. But you called our number one item in the very beginning when you said pralines. We can now say that we sell more pralines than anybody in the country.
I would believe
New Orleans.
That.
We have left them. They say praline, we say praline.
Uh-huh.
But we have left them in the dust.
Well, nobody can touch your pralines. Well,
thank you.
Nobody. And, you know, I can make a pretty good praline at home, but I'd so much rather have yours.
Well, you're the only person that I ever gave my recipe to. I don't know if you remember that. I hope you
don't. No, I don't. Well, listen, it's safe because I didn't know I had it.
I about got divorced from that.
Are you kidding?
Yes.
When did you give me the recipe?
I did it together one time on TV.
I don't have it.
Yeah, and I made it, wouldn't give it to everybody else, but I gave it to you.
No, no, no. Well, see, secrets are safe with me.
Yeah, I can know the feeling.
Because I forget so quickly.
Yeah.
Golly, bum, now I'm going to have to go back and watch every show to find that show. Well, listen, we got to take a quick break, Stan, and...
We're going to get to talk some more?
We're going to sing for our supper. Yeah, we're going to talk some more.
All right, good.
So we'll be right back.
Thank you.
The space that you live in really affects the way you feel. So my first recommendation is start by updating your window treatments with Smith & Noble. Smith & Noble's beautiful handcrafted blinds, drapes, shades, and shutters are custom made just for you, and they offer different service options to fit your needs. To get started today, contact Smith & Noble to get my special limited time offer, 25% off on your window treatments, plus free design consultation. Create a space that you're gonna love. For details about my special offer, go to smithandnoble.com/Paula. That's smithandnoble.com/Paula. Or call 1-800-659-3300. That's 1-800-659-3300. Okie doke. Well, we're back, Stan. With Stan the Candyman, Stan Strickland, that owns
Savannah's Candy Kitchen,
and also River Street Suites.
That's my kids,
right?
And now we've combined them.
That's his children. Y'all are a candy-making family.
We are. You know, my mom made candy in a place called Ross Pecan back on Highway 17 in the 40s.
No.
That didn't really have anything to do with me getting into candy business, but I was around it even as a kid, you know.
Uh-huh.
And our divinity recipe is my mom's recipe.
You're kidding.
And you know how hard divinity is to make.
Oh, listen, Stan, my mother was the queen of divinity. I can see that beautiful redheaded woman standing up there with those two spoons just dipping that beautiful divinity.
In Albany, Georgia.
And she never failed with it. All the women in our family would try to make it, and they said, I can't. Kari's just going to have to
make
it.
Yeah, we still struggle with it. We try not to make it ever when it's raining, you know.
Right. You can't make it on a rainy day.
And I don't know that we can teach the country how good divinity is, but in the fall, everybody loves the way it looks. And I think everybody still eats lots of it in the fall.
Oh, I just
and Christmas.
Do love it. And sometimes mine will turn out like Mama's, and sometimes it won't.
Oh. Well, we've got it now where we're doing it pretty much. I think we probably hand dip more divinity than anybody in the country. I've never found a machine.
You're talking about like this, call that.
We hand dip it. I've never seen a machine that would do divinity.
You hand dip every piece of divinity.
Yes. 500,000 pieces hand dipped.
No.
Yes.
And where is that done? Is that done here in Savannah?
We have a factory now that's 75,000 square feet.
I hadn't been to your factory, but I've heard it's bad to the bone.
Your boys have been.
Yes.
We do hand dip divinity.
And listen, I know your buddies with my husband. Don't ever let him in your factory. Just a word to the wise.
He comes by at Christmas every Christmas and gets something for the kids y'all help every year.
Yes.
He comes by and we donate all the stuff.
I know. Listen.
Michael loves working with that, and he does that every year.
Yes, I appreciate that. Years back, y'all, I started working with the Salvation Army, you know, and I told my children, I said, listen, you know, we've got more than we ever can need, and I think it's time for us to forget about each other and help tend to children that are not going to have anything. And they said, Mama, we are all in.
Yeah, I think your whole family's been involved in that.
Yes, the whole entire family. And so every Christmas Eve morning, we go to the Salvation Army, and we play Santa Claus. And course, one of the favorite things that's in their big old sacks is Stan's candy. Stan is kind enough to give us a lot of cakes and candies.
We'll always do that.
Well, thank you, Stan. You know, I've held fathers in my arms while they cried like a baby. And it's just,
You talk about with the Salvation Army.
Yes. Oh. Yes. And it just gives me great pleasure to be able to help people that need a hand up.
Yeah. They hadn't been as fortunate as we have.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. Well, so
I think
you've
always
help.
Been that way, even before we could. Even I can remember you back when you were the bag lady. Okay.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
We were needing handouts then instead of giving handouts.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
So those times have changed for all of us, for both of us.
Yes. I said, Lord, if I ever make it, I just want to be in a position to help other women. And finally, in 2012, we were able to start my foundation, the Bag Lady, the Paula Deen Bag Lady Foundation. And it's designed to help women and their children.
Well, I'm hoping that you'll come up with some kind of new recipe for the fall, maybe to have us work on, to be sold on Evine, maybe for this fall. If you
know,
come up with a new
item. I'll put my thinking cap on. Do you like dealing with apples or?
Well, you know, we're doing a lot of apples right now, but
doing the candied apples, which are.
You're thinking about baking with apples?
Yeah.
We haven't done much of that, so that'd be good. That'd be a good place to go.
You know what I love? I love. Like a baked apple. I wonder if we could come up with a candied baked apple. And I don't know how long that the life would be on them.
Yeah.
But, oh my gosh, I bake apples for me in my air fryer. My air fryer.
I've heard that air fryer special.
Oh, listen, it can be life-changing for you, you know, if you're wanting to cut back on your grease consumption and all of that, on your fats.
You think I need that?
I think you ate one too many pralines.
That's for sure. I'm trying to do better.
Listen, it's hard. Michael's on a diet, and I keep trying. You know, I try to practice moderation. Yeah. You know, just push back. And 'cause I can't do without the things I love. I can't go cold turkey.
Yeah. So you're cooking a lot different.
Not really. I did for 4 months, you know, to get the initial weight off. But then I started gradually adding things back, but I'm really trying to practice moderation.
I could use some of that.
And it's hard, you know, you have to slap your hand. But I've been baking a lot of apples in my air fryer, and to me, they're so good. So I was sitting here thinking about that candied apple that you do. If somehow you could do that and then bake it.
Would like a cherry flavor from the apple, or are you thinking about something with caramel on it?
I'm talking about something with caramel on
it. Okay.
Would it stick to it?
You know, that caramel, I worked years on that caramel recipe. I don't believe anybody's making as good a recipe as we are on caramel.
Oh, no.
We're making it by hand. We're making it in 30, 40-pound batches. That's small with the number of batches we are having to make.
Yeah. So, does your factory work 24/7?
No, we run two shifts, but not three. Uh-huh. And now when Christmas gets here in the fall,
will run three.
We'll ship 10,000 people a day into Christmas.
Holy moly.
And we keep tractor trailers backed up. And
holy
moving
moly.
And a bunch of that stuff you're going to sell.
Yeah.
Hopefully it's going to be your product.
Yeah. Well, I tell you what, it sounds like to me that Stan Strickland is probably having to weigh his money instead of count it.
I wish. Hey, I told my dad one time, I'm finally making more than I can spend. He said, I don't believe you. And he was right.
Oh, you can spend it pretty good.
I'm investing it. Wisely, boats, fishing.
Things that are important.
Things that are important. You remember that chocolate bar I made from you that time? That chocolate bar was
this
big with a picture of you on it.
Where'd he go?
You ate it, I think. I don't know. It weighed 30-something pounds, one chocolate bar, with your picture in the middle of it.
Oh, my gosh. We've had fun over the years.
We certainly have.
We've had fun.
And I hope we continue. I hope we got a lot more. Do you return?
Huh?
That's what I said.
No.
I don't think either one of us will ever retire.
No, honey, no. We got started late. We got to double up and catch up.
I'm with you.
Well, I appreciate so much you coming in. I know you're a busy man. It's hard to even get you on the telephone.
Well, I don't remember.
And
you
then
calling.
I held him up this morning, y'all, because I was like 30, 45 minutes late.
I should have known.
Yeah. Listen, you always pad Paula time.
Right. Pad Paula time. I like that.
Uh-huh.
Hey, I remember one time we had to turn a jet around and come back and get something you left from your makeup bag. So I understand the Paula time.
No. Did that happen? See, I
forgot
that. Oh,
yeah, that happened.
Too. No.
Yes. Yes, it did. We were going to New York. You were doing a show. It was a fancy food show. We had to turn around.
No.
Go, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Those are fun things.
I'm bad. Well, thank you, my friend.
Thanks for inviting me.
And
wish you
just
much
keep,
more success.
Thank you, and back at you. And I appreciate you making all those wonderful things. We're going to have to come up with some good things for fall. For
yeah,
Evine.
Come up with something new for us.
Yeah.
We'll try anything you give us, okay?
Okay.
All right, Paula, thanks. Come
on. Where are you going?
I'm going to fishing.
I've held him up. Well, thanks so much, honey. I love you.
Thank you.
We'll see y'all later.
Bye-bye.
The space that you live in really affects the way you feel. So my first recommendation is start by updating your window treatments with Smith & Noble. Smith & Noble's beautiful handcrafted blinds, drapes, shades, and shutters are custom made just for you, and they offer different service options to fit your needs. To get started today, contact Smith & Noble to get my special limited time offer, 25% off on your window treatments, plus free design consultation. Create a space that you're gonna love. For details about my special offer, go to smithandnoble.com/Paula. That's smithandnoble.com/Paula. Or call 1-800-659-3300. That's 1-800-659-3300.